Welcome in to the next installment of our Zoom interview series featuring the man, Butch Hobson, entering his third season as Chicago Dogs manager, joining us from his home in Alabama. How are you, Butch?
I'm good, Sam. How you doing, buddy? How's everybody in Illinois? I know it's been tough, and I've been thinking about everybody up there and praying for everybody.
We're doing well. We're not at the ballpark right now. You know, we're all spread across our homes, but always representing and, you know, staying in touch just like this over Zoom, over the phone, and just hoping to get back to Impact Field soon. How are you down in Alabama?
I'm good. You know, I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. My house is spotless. It's nothing to do but clean my house, but that's, you know what, we're going to all get through this, and we're going to all work together and do the things we need to do and be that person that we always to watch that cleaned everything, and they cleaned their hands all the time, they disinfected all the time, and we'd make fun of them. But that's what we've become. That's what we've got to become. So, you know, that's let's do it.
Is this the cleanest you've ever been?
Oh, definitely. And I'm a pretty, my daughters give me a hard time because they, Dad, you're clean, you're going to be clean, but you know, you always look neat, they tell me. And I don't like a mess, you know, but it's a little different when you're, you know, I mean, I'm disinfecting my handles of my truck when I get in or when I get out. I got the little bags of the sanitary wipes and my steering wheel. And, you know, I mean, we used to laugh at people like that and say, wow, are you kidding me? But that's what we got to be, y'all. That's it. That's what we got to be.
That's what we're doing. We're all clean freaks now. Yeah, other than cleaning, what have you been doing to pass the time at home?
Well, you know, I look, with not a lot of releases coming out now. There are some free agents out there that we've been speaking to. I'll take the morning and look at some things. When it comes to the team and still getting ready for our season when it opens in early July, I talked to Corey and DJ quite a bit. We've signed some players. We do have a few more contracts out to some guys. I like what we've done and some additions. I had surgery, I think, when you and I were talking. I had some surgery about 4 weeks ago, so part of my therapy is to walk. So I'll do 3 days, mile and a half, 2 miles, and a day off. Got my legs back under me. Try to stay in touch with my family. I have family here, and, you know, we go out to my oldest daughter's got a farm out here in Fonsdale. She's got a little swimming pool out there. So I'll go out there and we'll all meet and be outside, you know, and are 6 feet apart from each other. I don't go in their house. They don't come in mine. I've been watching a lot of ESPN Classic, a lot of the old World Series and in the, you know, late 70s, early 80s. I see, you know, I see guys that I played with and played against, and I miss baseball, you know, as we all do. I get out Tuesday mornings from 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. is the old goats morning at Walmart. You can only go at that hour if you're over 60. And I fit into that category. So I get to do my shopping and, I wear my mask and, you know, always wiping my shopping cart down. So I'm having a blast. I think I'm somebody I don't mind being alone. I know my family's right down the road or right phone call away. You'll make up for this lost time. I'm starting to read a little bit. I used to read a lot and I just kind of got away from it, but I've gotten back into reading.
What are you reading right now?
I'm reading this book called Babbitt, a book. It's right there on the thing. It was back in Mississippi, and it's about a minister in Mississippi, and and the things that they went through back in the 60s and 70s, just getting started on it. You know, I've read a lot of my, I like the Brad Thor books with the special ops guys. I like those types of books. I'm getting into reading a little bit more.
And I think you mentioned earlier, you have a grandbaby on the way out in California.
Yeah, I got a new, my third daughter, Polly's expecting, and baby's due late November, early December. Another little girl. They have one daughter. I'm excited about that. That'd be number six. Pretty excited.
Congratulations.
I'm really excited. They haven't had a chance to come. They came to Chicago when I was managing in Kane County in 17, and they love being up there. So hopefully once we get started, I can get them up to Chicago this year, up to the dog stadium, and they have a chance to meet everybody.
And Butch, you mentioned you're around the house a lot. You're cleaning, you're organizing, going through old stuff, reading. You know, obviously restaurants are closed right now. Have you been cooking a lot more?
Well, I usually cook. I don't go out too much. I mean, unless my daughters will call and say, let's meet, you know, let's meet at the Red Barn, or let's meet down at Mr. G's, or go out to the Fonsdale Bar and Grill when they were open. You know, we would meet, but usually I'm a pretty decent cook.
What's your specialty?
Mashed potatoes, cornbread, black-eyed peas, turnip greens, and white corn.
Love it.
I make the best cornbread you'll ever eat.
Love it. Maybe I'll come over and we can eat 6 feet apart in your backyard.
Yeah, perfect. Yeah. 6 feet of my little table right here.
Yeah, I could use some cornbread right now, some Butch cornbread. We'll bring it to Chicago when our season starts.
Yeah, well you know, I know what to get. I just need an iron skillet and some buttermilk.
All right, I'll provide that.
All right, sounds good, buddy.
And Butch, you mentioned you miss baseball. You know, you're watching on ESPN Classic, and you know we're going to get back in early July here in Rosemont. What's your favorite part about being at Impact Field, and what are you most looking forward to when we do get started again?
Well, the ballpark is unique. I really love the open concept that Sean and them, developed. It's different. It has a really clean feeling about it. The number of, of fans that we have that have adopted us now is I miss seeing all of them. I miss seeing all of y'all in the office, and the many vendors and security people that work around that ballpark. It's just that whole, to me, that whole place is just a class act. It's a class act. It really is.
Can't wait to have you back there.
They talk about St. Paul. You know, Impact Field and the Chicago Dogs are going to be back. And we're real close to being that. And, in my heart, we're already that. But, we're new. And it's the village of Rosemont is, to me, a very special place. You know, you make friends in this game, and you make friends with the fans. You make friends with, places you go to eat and meet new people. And the village of Rosemont is a really special little place. A little place, really special, fun place to be, and I can't wait to get back. Spent time. My son is going to play for us this year. I'm really excited about that. And actually, before you and I got on the phone, he's starting. He works for a little baseball facility. He's a really good instructor, and they've kind of made a promotion to him to maybe after the season is over, maybe doing some preliminary work during the season to take a facility they have and kind of franchise it and branch it out a little bit in North Carolina. And he called me about that. He was pretty excited about that. So I'm going to be, this will be the second time or the third time that he's played for me. 2016, he got released by the Blue Jays and came and played for me and had a tremendous, tremendous season in 90 games. Actually, the last day of the season, last weekend of the season, the Barnstormers, we were not in the playoffs, and the team we were playing, the Bridgeport Bluefish, were not in the playoffs, and Bridgeport's manager played for me. I think most everybody in this game has played for me somewhere along the line. Well, on Friday night, KC's getting his bat, and I'm not coaching third that game. DJ's coaching third. And I walk up to my son. I said, I got an idea. Tell me what you think of this. He said, okay. I said, I'm going to activate myself Sunday. I'm going to hit second, and you hit third. And I'm going to play third while you play first for one inning. He said, go for it. And I did it. I played. I think I became the oldest old goat to ever play the game at that point in time. But I played an inning. I struck out. I swung the bat an hour in the cage beforehand, and I barely picked the bat up when I got up to home plate. But it was something I had to do. It was something that I just, you know. But don't count on that happening again. That's not going to happen again. So,
how special was that to
it was awesome.
Be at third base and see your son?
It was awesome for me. And, you know, they really wanted me to do it at home. I had thought about it and mentioned, but you know what? The teams we were playing, you know, I had to make sure that it wasn't something that these, you know, it's teams that we were playing at that point in time were still battling for the playoffs. Mm. I would not have done it then. But you know what? I get pictures. You know, it's a memory that I'll never forget. And I think he feels the same way.
What does it mean to you to manage your son? You've done it before, and you're going to do it again here in Chicago.
Well, I've seen him grow. I mean, you know, he never had the opportunity to get to the big leagues. He's had some real big years in the minor leagues and has moved up to the highest level, being Double A for like 2 or 3 years. He's 28 years old now. He's 29 now. I've got too many kids now. I can't remember all their ages. He's a big, strong left-handed hitter. He's very, very good defensively at first base. He's a team player. He's actually going to pitch a little bit because in high school, he's a lefty. He's a big lefty. And in high school, he's like 94, 96. So he's throwing some bullpens. You know, I just told him, you know, we're 23-man roster sometimes, son. You know, he said, Dad, I'm ready. So he's throwing some bullpens, and if we ever have a chance to need him on the mound. But yeah, I'm looking forward to you know, all of you meeting him and him meeting all of you, and you know, some of his former teammates, like Gustavo was a teammate of his, Michael Kraus was a teammate of his. DJ has worked with him before. DJ worked with him when he was like, let's see, that would have been when he was like 4 and 5 years old. Was worked with him at first base and stuff like that. So, and DJ was his hitting coach when Casey came and played for me in Lancaster. So he's really excited about it, and so am I.
You alluded to some of the guys coming back too from last year. It was a great season. The team was only a few games out of the playoffs. Of course, Edwin Arroyo has been a mainstay from the start alongside like Tony Roselli, Victor Roach. He probably would have been league MVP just about any other year, except right. Keon Barnum obviously set the record for home runs and earned the MVP. How do you feel about some of the returners coming back from last year?
Well, I'm excited about, you know, I talked to Gustavo yesterday. He called me and, you know, hey, man, what's going on, man? Going to play ball? What are we going to do? You know how Gustavo, what a beautiful human being he is.
He really is. He's a ray of sunshine. Like, that's what I
yeah,
said.
Yeah, he is. He's always smiling. You know, and we signed a guy that he, a young shortstop that he's been working out with, that his name is Osvaldo Abreu, and he was a big prospect for the Nationals. And, but he's a visa guy and lives in the Dominican, you know, so I'm not sure how that's going to play out. So, but the guy, you know, Vic was excited about coming back. Edwin, you know, a fan favorite. Roselli, Tony. Tony's into this long driving thing. Did he tell you about that, or is he probably sending all stuff on this long driving?
No, he didn't tell me.
Yeah, he's doing all that. He thinks he's like King Kong with a golf club.
How long?
I don't know how far he hits it. I think he said he was in one the other day and he won it. So I don't know if he's traveling around or what he's doing. You never know with Roselli. That's the beautiful part about him. It's just Tony, you know. Mascheri will be back, Dahlberg, Harrison Smith, Goose is retiring. He's not gonna pitch anymore. Let's see here. Help me out. We signed a new center fielder, Michael Krause, who y'all are going to really like. This guy's a big 6'5".
A Canadian.
He's a big 6'5". His dad actually played a little bit of time, had a little short stint in the NFL, but he had many years in the CFL. Michael can fly. He's like a gazelle out there. He's got some thump in his bat. Brett Milazzo is going to be a fourth outfielder. Was get some chance to really get his feet a little more wet than we got him last year. But I like some of the things we've done. I really do. I'm excited. I'm excited about getting this thing started and getting back to Rosemont and I just walk right out there on that beautiful field and impact field and take a deep breath and say, okay, let's go.
I know opening day is always special, but this one's going to be the most special.
I agree. It means we beat this thing.
Mm-hmm.
And we've learned how to stay safe and keep ourselves safe in a lot of ways that we haven't done before.
Do you have any message for Dawgs fans who are watching?
Probably not anything that not everybody has always heard have already heard. I pray a lot right now. And that don't mean to say that I don't pray, but I pray more. I know that the man upstairs is going to handle all this and he's going to take care of us. Keep your distance. I'm standing at Walmart and this gentleman was behind me and he was right behind me and they've got markings on the floor and I said, sir, please, go to your spot. I'm in my spot. Don't be afraid to speak up. Keep washing your hands and your sanitizers. And I had a Clorox spray bottle and I'm spraying everything. So and I'm okay with it. I just know that I want to see my kids grow up and my grandkids grow up and my great grandkids grow up. And I want to get back to Rosemont and Impact Field. So let's all do the things that we're doing. And I'll be praying for everybody, for all of you.
Can't wait to be back. Certainly can't wait. And Butch, we're going to finish with a lightning round. I gave you a little preview of this before we hopped on. One minute on the clock. You've got to get in as many questions as you can. Just quick, rapid-fire answers. So you ready to roll?
I think so.
In the pressure cooker here. All righty. The timer starts now. What is the weirdest thing you've put on a hot dog?
Weirdest thing? Jelly.
Favorite day of the week?
Saturday.
Last song you listened to?
George Strait, the Old Troubadour.
Favorite holiday?
Christmas.
Would you rather be able to speak every language in the world or have the ability to talk to animals?
Oh, talk to animals.
Scale of 1 to 10, how good of a driver are you?
10.
Place you most want to travel?
Australia.
Favorite thing to do outside of baseball?
Hunt and fish.
Favorite junk food?
Dunkin' Donut. Krispy Kreme, cream-filled chocolate donuts.
All right, time's up. we end with the Krispy Kreme chocolate donuts. That sounds really good. I could go for some of those right now. I wonder if Krispy Kreme has curbside delivery.
I don't know. I get mine at Walmart.
Delicious. Walmart. Yeah. Delicious. Well, Butch, thanks so much for your time. Stay safe, and can't wait to see you here in Rosemont soon.
Me too, brother. Thank you. I enjoyed this. Let's do it again.